And what a sight to see. Lava entering Kapoho Bay, sending that massive plume of LAZE into the air. Although it's quite a sight, you definitely don't want to breathe in the LAZE. There's hydrochloric acid and tiny glass particles that can cause permanent lung damage. Scientists say luckily that plume is dissipating quickly. Also new tonight from civil defense, more homes have been destroyed, raising the total to nearly 160 homes either set on fire or buried under the lava. Howard went back into the evacuation zone tonight with the National Guard and joins us now with more. Howard.
Aloha, Marissa. We're coming to you from Pohuiki Road, just below Highway 132, and there you see over my shoulder, that is Fissure 8, which continues to pump incredible amounts of lava, shooting 200-300 feet up into the air. In fact, earlier today, we talked with geologist and geophysicist Jim Kawahikala, who told us that it's actually producing more magma right now than Pu'u'o'o did in its heyday. And that gives you an idea of the volume and then the river of lava that is making its way downrift. As we all know, overnight and early this morning, the lava finally hit the Pacific Ocean, but not before going through Kapoho and in the process taking out an estimated 40-plus homes. But it's not just the homes, it's the landscape that has forever changed. Down there, people, locals, for generations have been going to a place called Champagne Ponds. It's where children first learned to swim. Families have been gathering for decades. Well, now they only have the memories because the physical place is lost forever.
My wife's family had this beach home down in the beach lots area. It's a gated community. There's a lot of homes in there. We don't have no assessment as to how many homes.
As a civil defense director, it's like a flood, you know. It's just pouring out, covering everything in its path. Just incredible what it's doing.
Of course, another one of the great concerns is when that water hit the ocean, that huge plume of LAZE. We have incredible shots of what that looked like throughout the day. But that, of course, is a potentially very dangerous mixture of hydrochloric acid. Then the particles, the small, fine particles of glass that can be carried downwind. If you happen to be within that plume, you breathe that material in, that could be very, very harmful if it gets in your lungs or in your eyes and creates some long-lasting damage. But the big headline is the fact that those homes have been consumed. Still many, many homes down in vacation lands in Kapoho Beach Estate. So the potential for more disaster is out there as this lava flow continues to widen at the ocean. At last count, about a half a mile wide, and still hundreds of homes possibly in the path of the river of lava created by this fissure. It shows no signs of slowing down anytime soon. Marissa reporting from the Big Island. For now, we send it back to you in Honolulu.